Hey guys, it's Nick. Welcome to another episode of T-Minus 365. Today's episode, we're covering all the updates from Microsoft in February of 2023. If you follow along with my update videos in the past, you know I focus in on what's relevant to the MSP space, blocking out the noise from the 100 or so announcements that come from Microsoft each month. As a quick reminder, I also have these updates in white labelable format that you can subscribe to, which I'll link below on this video. As always, if this content's helpful, go ahead and like this video and subscribe to the channel. Otherwise, let's go ahead and dive in. Okay, a lot of announcements to cover today, but before we get into that, I just quickly wanted to remind you all, I do supplement this video with a blog post with more information about each one of these announcements and helpful links if you want to check that out after watching the full video. Getting into it here though, we're going to start with Microsoft Teams as we usually do, and this first one I'm really excited about is ultrasound howling detection in Microsoft Teams. You may not recognize that by that name, but you've likely experienced this pain point. Whenever you join a Teams meeting in the same room as another individual, you don't have your sound settings configured correctly, like you just have your Teams off mute, you likely experience this loud echo effect that's never ending, and it's really hard on your ears as well too. So what this feature is doing is automatically detecting that proximity of users being in the same room, joining the same Teams meeting, and will automatically mute the Teams meeting and the sound settings of the device to avoid what they're calling the howling effect within the Teams meeting itself. It's a really cool feature. It's going to be coming out early March, be complete by late March. Next one here, suggested files in one-on-one chats. If you're familiar with the suggested text within a chat, it's very similar, but Teams is basically detecting the intent to share a file, giving you a quick access, a little button to press to do so, versus having to take a couple additional steps to take that action within the chat itself. So this will happen in early March. The other one here is related to joining meetings from a calendar view on Apple CarPlay. So Apple CarPlay is the iPhone connecting to your vehicle there, that heads-up display with all of your apps, just bringing in support for Teams meetings as part of that as well too. Is it safe? Don't know, but they're coming out with it here for that ease of accessibility. This will happen in early March. Next one here, busy on busy end user settings. This is related to the telephony settings within Teams and just giving users the ability to dictate what happens when they're already on an existing call and how they want a new incoming call to be directed. So you can see that here in the screenshot, some new options there and some more granularity around the selection. This will happen in early March, be complete by mid-March. Last one here, many of you are familiar with, have been keeping up with the announcements, but Teams Premium is now available and it includes a lot of popular features many people are gravitating towards, which is that OpenAI GPT level technology being baked in for enhanced level meeting AI capabilities and things like that. This is going on right now as far as promotion goes for pricing at a 30% discount. We're able to get it at $7 per user per month USD versus 10, which it will be in July when this promotion ends. So this is available now if you want to check that out. Shifting into Microsoft Intune here. The first one is related to another name change, classic Microsoft move here, but shifting back to calling the Endpoint Manager Admin Center the Intune Admin Center. You'll see that reflected already today. I think it's only a matter of time before they do the same with the URL, or we'll see on that. The other one here I thought was interesting is this commercial driver and firmware servicing API that they come out with as well too. That's baked into the Windows Update for Business deployment service. If you're familiar with that, the Windows Update rings that you can configure within Microsoft Intune. This is related to the OEM providers that Microsoft might work with as well too, to push out the driver and firmware updates that you'd be able to control. You can do it today via the Graph API, and there's no ETAs on when this will be coming to Intune, but it's an eventuality as far as everything that we're seeing in the documentation. So we'll just have to wait and see when that comes out. Another new product here, Microsoft Intune Suite. This is going to be available on March 1st. And this is going to include both a P1 and P2 option, plan one, plan two. And it will include some more of the advanced endpoint management solutions. One of which I'm excited about that you can see in the screenshot is that endpoint privilege management, where you're able to have PIM or PAM-like activity on elevating privileges for users on devices to be able to download apps as a local admin, for instance, as a use case. So a lot of cool features coming here. Pricing will be coming out that March 1st date as well too, so we'll have to see about that. But it'll be interesting to see how that is baked into the Intune offering over time. Shifting into Microsoft Viva here, this first one is schedule send suggestions, and this is part of Viva Insights. You need a Viva Insights subscription in order to access this service or this feature. But as you can see in the screenshot here, it's going to allow you to schedule a send based off of the working hours of the individual that you may be talking to, as in this example that you see here. This will happen late February, be complete by late March. The other one here for Microsoft Viva also has a requirement for a Viva Insights license, but as you can see in the screenshot here, it's allowing you to organize and categorize all of your meetings so you can see where you're spending a lot of your time. And as you can see in the screenshot, that may be from your one-on-ones, your product reviews, operations, and you can better manage how your productivity is looking from a meeting standpoint. So this will happen in early March, be complete by late March. Shifting into Exchange here, this is just a permissions update here. I thought it would be good to know since a lot of us do access the Quarantine Admin Center today. But starting in June of 2023, they won't allow you to access the Quarantine Admin Center just being an Exchange administrator. You do have to have a specific designation of a Quarantine Administrator, Security Administrator, or Global Admin in order to access that portal. So just a heads up for accessibility there. Last one here for Microsoft Exchange is this ability to allow end users to upgrade legacy distribution lists into Microsoft 365 groups. So if you have users that are looking to maybe have a mailbox dedicated to their distribution group or have a Teams channel dedicated around it, they want to upgrade to a Microsoft 365 group because that allows you to do so. And this is giving you, as you can see in the left-hand screenshot as the admin, the ability to prompt the owner of that distribution list to upgrade the distribution list into a 365 group, which you can see on the right-hand side from the screenshot there from the email. This will happen mid-February, be complete by mid-March. Shifting into the SharePoint here, this is also related to another product announcement. This is Microsoft Syntex, and this is related to the pay-as-you-go preview. But Microsoft Syntex was announced at Ignite, and if you're familiar with the AI Builder components as part of Power Automate, it's basically the same thing, just packaged into a different offering that's linked to SharePoint. But it can do similar things like being able to scan and process invoices for you as far as whenever you upload them as documents into your environment and convert them into different Automate flows as well too. So right now, this is $5 per user per month in addition to pay-as-you-go pricing for the amount of compute that you're using with the AI services. But that is free currently till the end of March. So maybe something you want to check out, especially if you can create a lot of automation around certain processes like invoice processing. OneDrive here, very straightforward announcement, giving a favorites option in the OneDrive experience. So you can favorite files that you can access on the left-hand side. You can see in the screenshot here, just an easy way to access documents you might be working on periodically or for a short period of time, but you're accessing almost every day. This will happen mid-March, be complete by early April. Final section here, this is the admin section. If you're a Microsoft partner and you have customers, then you're looking at GTAP closely, I would hope, right now. But the timelines here keep shifting, and so the recent announcement from Microsoft here is that May 22nd is now the deadline here where they're going to move existing DAP relationships to GTAP automatically for you and choose the permissions and roles that are part of those. And they will strip DAP relationships off of your customers at that point in time as well too. And then on March 15th is when they're going to come out with more timeline announcements as it relates to not being able to create new DAP relationships, what roles are defaulted whenever you're, you know, accessing or creating new customers within Partner Center, and then when they're going to retire the bulk migration tool. I have a lot of resources on GTAP if you want to check them out. I'll link them below here on this video as well. Final announcement here, just related if you're running or if you have a customer running an environment with Windows Server 2008 or 2008 R2, this is the ESUs or the extended security updates that you can purchase as well too, just to help you while you're trying to transition to a more modern service itself, and this will be available up until January of 2024. Okay guys, that's everything that I had for you in today's video. Comment below which feature or update that you're most excited about, along with any questions or comments on the things that I covered today. As always, if this content's helpful, like and subscribe to the channel if you want to see more content around Microsoft and the MSP space. I'll see you guys in the next video.